say the mage is going to be the path that we take with our combat, I'd still like us to be able to use each of the different combat styles at any time. So I think we'll certainly be coming back to melee again very soon, and I think perhaps when we become a member we'll have a look at range. Perhaps we'll get a multi-cannon, something like that. Okay, so we're going to give this a bit of a break and start the Knight's Sword quest. I also received a camo top from a random event. I don't think it does anything, but it's a nice little gimmick. So, to start the quest, we need to go and speak to the squire in the courtyard of the White Knight's Castle in southern Falador. Well, I mean, southern Falador is a little bit vague. It's basically all of Falador, that castle. It's so big. But I suppose you could say it's southern Falador. It takes up probably a third of the overall city. This is quite a good quest for us to do right now, as well as I believe it gives us quite a lot of smithing EXP, and I'd quite like us to get some higher smithing. Our mining is going ahead a little bit, so to have our smithing in a good place would be great, so we can start mining other ores and smithing other metals. Okay, so we're in Falador. Sometimes there are imps around this area, so keep an eye out. Perhaps we'll find another bead. Right, so we need to speak to the squire in Falador Courtyard. Okay, that must be him. Squire of Sir Vivin. Oh dear, so he's gone and lost his knight sword. Let's see if we can make a new one. So the sword was made by Imcano dwarves, who are dwarves who lived many generations ago, but no one really knows if the tribe exists anymore. Okay, so we're going to have to try and track them down. Just to start by talking to Reldo. So Reldo is in Varric Castle, in the library in Varric Castle, so we'll need to go and teleport to Varric. But I've just spotted an imp. Let's go and get him. This time, only a ball of wool. But that's okay. We'll find those beads. I like the inf- it's just fun trying to find these different coloured rocks. Let's put these in here. You are a party item, party clothing or casual clothing, so that can go in there. We found ourselves an amulet mould as well. So I think we can also start the Shield of Arav quest with him. So that might be something we come back to do at some point soon. Okay, so the Imkando Dwarves. Okay, so apparently the Imkando Dwarves were wiped out by a barbarian. Southern peninsula of Asgardia, they dislike strangers and love red berry pie. Well, I just so happen to have a red berry pie. However, let's use our Lumbridge home teleports. I haven't quite got a Valador teleport yet, but hopefully by the next video we will, and we'll be able to jump across the free areas of the world a lot more easily with our four teleports, or three, seeing as the Lumbridge teleport is available twice in different formats. Now then, I did have a little look into the episode itself because I do remember the quest, but I don't remember all of the finer details, so I know that we need red berry pie, two iron bars, and a steel pickaxe, so we'll take each of those with us. What I might just do as well is replenish our prayer, and that can be done by praying at an altar, usually within a church. So, as I was walking towards so we've given him the red berry pie. He's quite a, I have to say, he's quite a portly fellow, isn't he, this dwarf? By Gothics. Special sword for us. Okay, so we now need to go and speak to the squire. Perhaps this will be a good opportunity for us to grab some food as well. So it looks like we're going to be running back to Falador and back down north-south. It's like running from Lumbridge to Varric in a way, so it may take a little bit of time. I'm going to jump back to Falador now. I'll meet you there shortly. So we're back with the squire. So we need to get a portrait. In Sir Vivin's room. Okay, so let's... Sir Vivin. So we need to open this door, come outside, close the door, and search inside the cupboard. And we found the portrait. Good stuff. We need to make sure he wasn't in the room with us. That could have been a problem. Start making our way back towards the dwarf. I think I'll go and do a bit of preparation. I might change. I've taken the wizard's garments that I had on off, so they're now in my inventory, along with the staff and the runes. Do we need to speak to the squire again? I'm not sure. Okay, so he's not fussed as long as we get the sword. So what I think I'll do is I'll remove the items I have from the inventory, from our inventory, and I'll wear the black armor that we recently purchased, as I think that will provide us with better defense. The reason why I've restored my prayer, restored our prayer, and I'm swapping out the wizard robes for armor, is that we'll be going into a dungeon to get the blurite ore that we need to create this sword. Inside the dungeon there are high level ice warriors and ice giants, but it's the ice warriors we need to look out for, as I don't believe the giants will be too much of a problem. I'll see you back at the Imkando Dwarf in a moment so we can finish off the Night Sword. Okay, so we've just arrived back at our friend's house, Thurgo. So, we're now going to go and extract the blurite. This could be potentially hazardous. I've made sure that we've got the best possible defense for this. We've got our full armor on. They are, all of them, the Ice Warriors and the Ice Giants, melee attackers. So they will try and attack us with swords and clubs. So hopefully everything we have should be sufficient, and all we need to do is mine one ore. That's all we need, one ore. So if we're in quickly and out quickly, this shouldn't be too much of a problem. We have hobgoblins nearby. Okay, well that's okay. That's fine. He's a little bit too far behind us. Ah, we've got another one attacking us now. Right, let's start running, shall we? So, we're now in the area where the ice giants will be, signified by the ice. Oof, now this could be a problem. No, wrong way. We definitely do not want to go this way. We should be alright. Good stuff. Right, let's get out of here. We'll eat our bread. We'll drink some wine. Good. So, just a moment. Okay guys, we're back in Falador Castle for the final time in this video. We've got the blurite sword in hand, and all we need to do now, hopefully, is speak to the squire. So, we've retrieved the sword. Ah. learn how to steal weaponry. Fantastic. Ah, the sun's coming through the window to the right of me. It feels beautiful. Yeah, so we're on to steal. Which is great. I think we're getting closer to being able to try some of the Slayer quests, but I'd like to leave Dragon Slayer until the end. Possibly the hardest or longest free-to-play quest. I wouldn't say it's hard. At our level, I suspect. Well, it would be very hard, but the anti-dragon shield all around that, but we'll try. Perhaps we'll do Demon Slayer or Vampire Slayer maybe in the next video. Perhaps we'll try an easier one again, or we could have a look at Black Knight's Fortress. I was thinking of doing that one for this video, so perhaps we'll do that one next, seeing as we're already in Falador. For now, thank you all very much for watching. I hope this has been a lovely, relaxing experience for you. And until the next time.